The preceding program may contain ratchet language, buffoonery, and raw humor, and is intended for mature audiences only. Listener discretion is advised.
System loading. Ready.
They're back.
Reach around
radio.
Clap for a nigga with his rapping ass. Blow a stack for your niggas with your trapping ass. Clap for a nigga with his rapping ass. Blow a stack for your niggas with your trapping ass.
This is your girl, Faith Evans.
Hey, yo, what's up? This your boy, Uncle Luke.
What's up? This is Howard Hewitt.
This is Corrupt Young Gotti.
Yo, this is Terry Crews.
What up? It's your boy, Guy Tori.
This is Ernest Thomas.
Hey, what's up now? This is your boy, John B.
What's up? This is Anthony Hamilton.
What up, y'all? It's your nigga, Dub C, a.k.a. Skip, the motherfucking Barracuda. You are now Reach Around Radio. Tune the fuck in. Stay tuned in. Turn it up. Nia!
Yeah.
I was in reverb.
Yeah, me too. I was like, damn, I'm good.
It's Reach Around Radio. It's your boy Speed Doggy Dog. To all the beautiful ladies out there trying to get with somebody for the holidays, your boy is here, ladies. Get at me.
Speedy Claus.
Speedy Claus is here, baby.
And eat a whole bunch of ho-ho-hos.
Love eating them hoes.
Only well, I did gifts. See a picture on your page.
Say your name, motherfucker.
I seen your picture.
Say your name.
Say my name.
Say your name.
Me and my girl. Finally.
Look at him. Like,
what are y'all talking about? Just say your goddamn name, man.
Here comes
Michelle.
The bride.
That's
your
name. Hey, Michelle.
It's the bride. Hi, Michelle.
Hey, Michelle.
Poetess. I'm the poetess.
It's your girl, world traveler, Claudia Jordan.
Yes, it is.
No more space in my passport.
I like to brag.
Yes. Getting vaccinated. Anyways, what's up, y'all?
Chilling.
You gotta say your name.
Let me do this.
Well, he does it first.
Because I'm standing on top of this comedy castle. Wait for this next topic to tackle. It is the Mr. 123 Knox. Baby!
And you know, TDP. It's the most ignorant. With the least pigment, it's the white boy. RT is the house.
And I want to thank y'all for coming out right now here at Club Fluffy's. It is the Christmas holiday, so we're doing Christmas melodies here at the Club Fluffy's. Teeter, you work in the coat check room for me?
Speedy, we have the holiday coat hangers. We have fluffy girls. We have beautiful girls like Claudia Joy that are intermingling.
Hey, let them in.
Girls who smoke weed like Poetess.
Hey. I stopped.
Impossible.
What?
And RT, any drink specials for the ladies tonight?
Yes, we do have Hennessy chewables.
Wow. I could blow a bubble with Bob.
Let's get it in, ladies, like this.
Hit it.
You give me all that jive about things you wrote before I was alive.
KB, these are the snack cakes.
Ain't even 1970. Now I'm the guy named Curtis Blow, and Christmas is one thing I know. So every year, just about this time, I celebrate it
with a rhyme.
That was actually written down.
How do you spell that? H-U-H-U. Santa Claus. My rap about to happen
like a demon. You I want to hear, I'm sure he'll play it later. Santa Claus goes straight to the ghetto from the dog pound.
Straight to the ghetto.
I don't remember that one. You don't remember that one?
Well, they play that in Boston.
No, we didn't get that.
Get that one.
Straight to the suburbs.
Right. RT heard of it.
Wow. I heard of it.
So it's good to see everybody here. Pretty much everybody. Pam's on her way, I guess.
Pam's birthday's coming up.
Yeah. See, Murdy, you look good.
Thank you.
Titties all out, or is that just the brassiere?
She's East Coast now.
Is that the brassiere, or is that you?
It's both. I gained a little weight. You know, I'm a chunky little
thing. It's the Nor'easter.
Is somebody in there? You got a little
baby?
Uh-oh.
Claudia been getting it in.
She's coming to the party plus one.
I'm eating for two.
I'll never forget when I told Speedy that I was pregnant.
Hey, I hate you.
What happened, Claudia?
Go be the godfather.
Remember
I
that?
Hated you.
Speedy sent me a text, like a heartfelt text, like,
I open up like a fucking lawn chair.
Like a sucker.
Like, I'm here for you if you need anything. And I was like.
And all I kept visualizing, like, you looking at the phone going, this stupid motherfucker, watch this girl.
Oh, it was so funny. I really reeled him in and really got him emotionally attached to the imaginary fetus, the baby ghost. And then I flushed it down the toilet.
I even had a name for it and everything.
Let's name him Charlton.
He wanted to be your, what do you call that?
Godfather?
Midwife.
No, midwife. Exactly.
So you're saying Speedy want to breastfeed for me?
Here's a hot tub of water.
She's dilated.
He wanted to carry the baby for me.
Yes.
He wanted to be the surrogate mother.
Sarah Lee.
I was truly like, hey, I was going to be like in 60, whatever the fucking movie was. Hey, if a dude want to be with you, fuck that. I got your back. I'll be that baby daddy.
He was going to adopt your baby.
Aww. I'm the pappy.
Can you imagine that?
I don't even didn't have Down syndrome.
Well, he is a good dad.
But does he feed them, though?
Yes, I do.
Like, they'd be sneaking out.
My kids got a great Christmas this year. Great. This is
really?
And my nephew, I took care of my nephews.
Wow, where you get money from?
Watch your tongue.
The other daddies.
Well, he does work at SeaWorld on the weekend.
What you mean y'all out of mackerel? Daddy, you did give me that bed made out of fish.
How did you come in so fast with the fucking sack on her teeth? And then this stupid one over here.
What is that? I look him down on the tail. Like, yeah. That dolphin? Back man may just be like backing it up.
Stick that in your blowhole.
Because I'm a gay fish.
Hey.
They had another episode with Kanye on South Park.
It's like Kim,
Kim is a hobbit.
Like, a hairy hobbit. A hairy hobbit.
So, bitch, are you the hobbit or not?
So, bitch, let me get this straight, bitch.
Yeah, let me get this straight, bitch. Why are you not the hobbit again?
That was hilarious. That was a
funny joke. We won't have her on there, guys. That's a gap.
Who cares?
What are you doing for Christmas?
Going to the Bay Area, of course.
Yeah.
Down there for about
a week.
Are
y'all coming to Fox having a party this weekend?
Are we invited?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Is Wayne Wizzle invited?
One never knows.
Oh, shit. Hey, can we can block that out, right? Wayne going to blow me up.
Hey, Speedy.
Is it Saturday?
Yes.
I heard about it.
You going?
I don't know if I'm going to stay that long.
Okay. Maybe. You'll be off the jet? Yeah. Oh, you gotta be
we need to go there early
this year's
and
be...
set up a table. Should we do a Reach Around Radio broadcast?
Broadcast.
I don't see why
we
not.
We should. That would be hot.
That'd be hilarious.
Speedy?
Speedy, hook it up.
They're already doing the foxhole. Look here.
Who's on the foxhole?
Are we doing the foxhole?
No. Speedy.
No, I'm playing.
We're doing the oxhole.
So anyway, I was going to say, you have to be suited and booted this year. They want people to look fly.
Oh, I got a dress. I'm ready.
Fly.
I got a suit. I'm ready.
You want everybody to look fly?
What? Teeter in a suit?
I got my jean shorts ironed.
The ones with the frizzle at the bottom.
You better believe it.
So what's a black tie?
Yeah, it's fancy, huh?
Not black tie, but you gotta look
dress up.
Can't wear no baseball hats and jeans and sneakers.
Be a lot of I bet you.
Right. Gonna be a lot of struggle hairlines out there. Don't you think? A lot of struggle hairlines.
Santa, if you can just please bring me a new hairline.
I hate my barber. Them motherfuckers, they cut your shit back so you have to come back. That's the whole get back.
He hates you.
Anyway, they cut. Fellas know. They hit your shit back. So when it grows back, you're like, damn, I need a haircut.
So it's the barber's fault?
Pretty much.
Oh, okay. So they created a receding hairline?
Yeah, he cut you back across 110 feet. Won't let the follicles go free.
Ooh, baby. You didn't want to be late today
fool.
Either?
No.
Show up. So you can pick that up on Dandruff Music.
What's everybody want for Christmas?
I'm just focused on having a new studio. So anybody that wants to give me gifts, in lieu of gifts, make a donation to my crowdfunding campaign that we are starting January 7th. Shout out to E40. He donated 10 bottles of Earl Stevens for donors.
Just perks.
Okay. So nice. We're going to get it started. We're working to have our own studio for Reach Around Radio.
We're going to raise some money, folks.
Yeah.
That's right.
POTUS, there was something on one of the pages, but you had a little run-in, too, yourself.
What?
Love is in the air. That's all I'm saying.
With
you,
what?
You got some dick?
No, no. She ran into some. She ran into.
Ran into the dick?
Dishes.
Dish. Oh God, I wasn't gonna bring dishes up.
It's on the page.
Wow.
It's on the page. It's on the ladies'
liquid
page.
Liquid soap. Told about it.
No, we, well.
Look at the glow.
Since, no, there's no glow.
You are glowing.
There's the no glow.
She glow.
It's the lighting, fellas.
They're Peter. Like dawn to me.
It's the light. No, me and Dishes hung out Friday. Ordered
he
some.
Dishes smash.
We're just friends. ordered some Chinese food and watched the Lakers get their ass.
What did he order?
Oklahoma.
What did he order? Some sweet them. Young coochie.
Did you play with his chopstick?
And you know, I was really surprised at how he looked. I thought he was like some thug, like. Weed head, you know, wow. Two strikes, man. Impossible.
What's she saying
that's
about
what
you?
I thought.
Yeah. What does he look like?
Hello, Felicia.
Very Hello. Clean cut, distinguished.
Yes.
Salt and pepper.
Very, yes. He looks like,
Like Uncle Phil?
Swagged out.
Uncle Phil.
He's thin and tall, actually.
Impossible.
Yeah, he's tall, okay. Handsome.
You guys look cute together. Like, yeah. You look like a grown, like an adult couple.
I have a PhD in rolling blunts.
Do you miss him? Do you miss him? Would you like to be with him?
You know what? I thought, now this is real talk. I thought I was like 100%, not 100%, maybe 80% over the dude.
No.
So when he came over Friday night, I was like, the next day I was kind of tore up.
Wow. You started scrubbing dishes.
So you mean to tell, he didn't hit, but you was crying?
I wasn't crying. I mean, was, I was just feeling.
Your emotion.
Just feeling him, you okay. know? So.
That's what he said.
Why can't it be?
No, it's cool. I'm cool. I'm ready to meet somebody new. To go around. For the new year, I'm probably gonna meet the one.
Not gonna.
The I one? Doubt it.
Yeah. Wow, you guys are so negative.
Look at negative Nancy.
It's not about being negative.
See, they don't encourage
She's
love
mean.
Here.
She's
well,
mean.
No I can't wait to get to you, Claudia. But Speedy, what have you been
You're
up
a
to?
Mean one.
Not when I'm around him. I told him too. I said my crew says. You know, I'm the mean bitch, but when I'm around you, I'm soft as butter.
You complete me.
You melt.
Porsche, you know what your
horoscope?
No. Your
it's your story.
Your poetry name is?
What?
Maya Mingelo.
Aw, I'm not that mean.
You roast the shit out of that joke.
I rise.
My anger rise.
I rise while you sit down.
As for me, I just want my movie to get done, which it looks like it's going to get done. All-Star Weekend is going to happen.
Okay.
With Justin Timberlake and Ken John with Fox.
Right.
Are you going to hire any other people here for your movie?
No. Just Teeter.
That movie's not going to happen.
Got to have a white guy there.
Yes! Somebody's
got
to talk to what?
Honest John.
So that's all you want? You don't
well,
want?
No, you might need insurance.
Not what
for
I
him.
Want.
You might
I,
die.
I said I'm happy that okay. it's going to happen. So,
okay.
Because that'll get me everything I want. Then I'll be, I might come in like, bitches, can't be here today. But I'll come and bring a silhouette or some shit. Anyway, so that's what I want.
You saying you'd be too big for Reach Around Radio?
Oh, wow.
Okay, your turn, cleavage.
That's it. But what about your Facebook status? Like, you were very loving. You showed love, and I thought that was very sweet of you.
Are you talking about the picture of him and...
He put a picture up on
Mrs. Speedy.
Mrs. Speedy.
Mrs. Speedy Claus.
You promised to take this woman and love
I thought
home.
That was sweet. I was
too.
Like, it's about time.
Yeah.
Shit.
Speedy is love in the air.
How many years a bitch got to put in to get claimed on Facebook? Goddamn. The bitch been putting in work
hilarious.
For 5 years doing free PR for you, driving you everywhere, giving you gas money, buying you sneakers, watching your kids. You finally.
Who did that?
Sucking your dick. I'm just saying.
Wow.
Finally,
is that what you call it?
You finally showing love. She give you this phone?
Put that in your blowhole.
No, you guys look cute and happy together. And I liked her brown hair. Looks less white.
Wow. Moving on.
Thank
no,
you.
No,
we're giving
you
props. We like
it.
It's okay. Mixed baby time. Mixed baby time.
Between the two of them,
Teeter.
I got about 12.
I mean, I'm sorry.
Wow.
Will you guys have a baby together? You think?
No.
Really?
No kids.
Really? Too late.
No kids.
1 minute.
So you got neutered?
Hey.
No, I don't.
Remember to get your pet spayed and neutered.
My shit is still good.
Still good.
Speaking of that, we're going to have a special guest for Price is Right coming up.
Oh, shit, yes, we
are.
Former.
I'm waiting on Claudia to give me the come on in here.
Ladies and gentlemen from Cleveland, Ohio.
Yeah.
Yeah. So what have you been up to, Claudia?
Brosto.
I traveled.
Brosto, California.
I went to Africa. in Plaza. Yeah. I went to Nigeria.
Oh, to adopt a baby.
A city you like.
So you went to the place where all the emails come from.
You're even cute enough over there.
Bring number four back out again.
Little dusty.
I was like, Claudia was over there. All she said was, they don't use deodorant here. No,
We had a code word. Every time we got into a cab, me and my friends, we were like, grilled onions. Grilled onions. You know, the BO smell was this. But it was really hot. In their defense, it's hot. Most people are living off $100 a day. So a week.
So you
I'm sorry. A month. A month.
That'd be great.
A month.
They're rich. They balling.
It was a month. I'm sorry. A month. $100 a month.
So you was killing.
Well, how's the cost of living there, though?
Well,
deodorant is expensive. Let's put it that way.
It's $200.
This is a week's worth of work.
The gap between the rich and the poor is absolutely ridiculous. It's like 20 people that have ridiculous money, like billions, and then the rest are surviving off, like I said, like $1,000 a year.
Wow.
You know, so it's pretty sad. Everybody's hustling, you know, trying to sell anything in the streets. Mm-hmm. It's kind of sad.
But this is Nigeria?
But then
Did you meet the dude that sent me my email?
Probably so. So I hosted their first ever music award show, kind of like their Grammys. Mm-hmm. It was me and this a local guy that's like a radio personality in Takara. Mm-hmm. They put us in like the traditional gear, which I didn't like. It was
African stuff.
It was very hot.
Was it pictures?
Huh?
Did you take any pictures?
Yeah, I got pictures. Okay. And what else happened? Some of the artists are dope as hell. Like, they have like a kind of a Caribbean / hip hop kind of thing going on, and their artists are making tons of money right now. Mm-hmm. And then we went on the yacht of the world's richest black man. He's worth $22 billion, and he makes he's not oil and gas. He makes his money through commodities. Like,
that's who you're pregnant by?
No, no, no.
Oh, my bad.
No,
the love boat.
Listen, my ab rule still applies with rich people. So yeah, he 60% of all the commodities coming into Nigeria go through him, like cement, sugar. Like, he's so paid, it's ridiculous. That yacht was incredible. So then I went to Dominican Republic for a vacation. That was fun. So
World traveler.
Ask her, did she get her some?
Did you get some plantain?
She said she's pregnant.
I'm up.
Injection. Somebody injected something.
No, it's just my top, and I gained.
Is it the bra?
It's both.
Bra. No, it's not. I've seen your titties.
No, you haven't.
Yes,
you only see them in bras.
They're either bigger or more tan. Somebody I can't figure it out.
It's a tan. It's the shirt. It's super low cut.
Maybe if I stare longer, I can figure it out.
You guys ever go to DR, go to the Hard Rock Casino. It's an all-inclusive resort. And you can, like, drink and eat as much as you want.
Oh,
and
shit.
And they have casinos. I did win money, so it's good times.
Damn.
Wow. Nice.
You did get in the casino?
I can't see this titty. Can you move this? Thank you.
Wow.
You're good?
So when is the baby due? When are you going to have a baby?
Let's see.
It'll be a September baby.
December, January, February.
It's September baby.
Yeah, September.
September?
A Virgo. Damn.
Damn, I fucked you that long ago?
Damn.
Well, sure got a pretty mouth.
This one had a dream about him hitting it.
What?
I did.
Yeah, I didn't even hear about this. Please tell me about
this. No, I just had a dream that me and RT was kicking it.
Uh-oh.
And he was on top of me. He was kissing. And then I said,
it's a hell of a dream.
Smoke on this blunt, bitch.
And I ain't never been with a white boy.
Wow.
And I said,
it's time to leave it to Beaver.
I was like,
get in there, Wally!
We got to find a condom.
Be Dennis the Menace up in that
before
ass.
I could find the condom. Oh, so maybe, I don't know how it was.
Maybe he went raw dog on you.
No,
I hope I woke so. Up.
He's still in your dream. He's still studying your dream going, where the condom at, bitch?
Damn.
It's a trip when you have a dream, a sexual dream about somebody that you don't even.
I have fucked both of y'all.
Really?
In my dreams, it was on you. I beat it up.
No.
Wow.
Clearly a dream. Because when you had the opportunity to grind against me, there was nothing.
I don't want to grind.
We had no lift off.
I want to put
you
it
was
in.
A two poop,
did you say no lift off?
No lift off.
Sleepy D.
He's got a rocket with no launcher.
Speedy, I'm a grinder. I like to grind. That's what makes a girl wet.
Wow.
The grinding, the anticipation.
No. I just got wet. Shit.
Yeah.
So if you got to be able to
anyway,
grind.
Anyway, Teeter, what you doing?
No.
Why are you mad at me? Because you can't get an erection.
Right.
Oh, damn.
He's got an innie.
Look how he's looking at me. So smug. Adorable.
Yeah, this seat was free last time. Now your ass is here.
You missed me. Peter, how you been?
I've been good. You know, I was thinking about the getting wet and grinded.
Oh,
and
I know. I'm sorry.
I know. I lost concentration.
I'm in a sexual mood. I'm sorry.
Oh, okay. Shit. Well, we got some alcohol out here.
Yeah, I know. I brought some. I roofied myself before I got here.
That's funny.
What have you been up to, TDP?
Just trying to promote this show. We're on iTunes, for those who don't know.
That's right. You can pick up our Reach Around Radio app.
We got an app.
And getting ready for the new year, we got these scripts coming up. Hopefully, Speedy's will be before mine, so I can get a little advance on my situation. Mm-hmm. But everything's looking good. You know, we got this new year coming up, and I'm just happy.
What do you want for Christmas? Like, you sound so excited.
I know. You can barely contain yourself.
I don't want that for Christmas. It's another day to me.
Right.
But, you know.
Right. No, I'll be glad when the holidays are over.
Bah humbug.
Yeah.
Yeah, right.
None of y'all got no kids. That's why I sit there.
Good.
Well, somebody.
That's the best part of it.
Good.
Of
it. I got my niece. They hit me up. Yeah, we want the dollhouse. Okay. Well, you can play with it in the store.
my daughters want that dollhouse. It's $150. I went, y'all gonna live in that little motherfucker. Shit.
No, I was going to say what you get your kids, but they might be listening.
So. No, Brett, yeah, okay.
Yeah.
There is this dope dog, though. It's a black dog called Doc something. I'll figure it out. And my daughter loves this dog. She's
What's it called, Doc?
She's a doctor.
Oh, that's good.
Wait, it's a black dog?
Don't do it.
Hey. What were we going to say? Dr. Pepper?
That's what I was going to say. You wake up in the morning, oh, my shit is gone. Mom, the black dog robbed me. How did he get everything out with his little bitty hands?
A black chuckle.
It's called Doc McStuffin. And she's a black dog. And she's a black doctor dog.
Are you getting it for your?
Yeah.
Oh,
she loves it. That's nice.
Aw, good for her. So Teeter,
got another black joke?
A black doctor. Black doctor. No.
It's your turn, RT. What you been up to?
Oh, just hanging out, having a good time.
I've been doing shows.
Being white.
Been doing shows. Yeah, being white.
Dating.
It's been great. No, not really dating. I don't really do that. Yeah, more mating than dating.
You're a mater.
Now I must mount you.
Prepare the hole.
Have you mated with any white women lately?
No.
Still white women.
Any in the year? Any in 2013?
2013, yeah, yeah.
Latinos?
Yeah, white, yeah. Latino too.
Mm.
Japanese?
No Japanese.
Oh, so.
Oh, so.
No. Black, I'm black, yeah.
Sisters?
Sisters, yeah.
An abundance?
Few. I wouldn't say, how much is an abundance?
Like more than
seven?
Three. More than three?
Yes, more than three for sure, yeah.
Wow, wow.
Sure. Running through our race, huh?
Yeah, I'm trying to bring the 40-yard dash times down. These vertical jumps are getting out of control. You got to lower the bar.
How about Sonny? You want to come in and talk about the new bike? Come on in.
He got a new bike?
Well, he got a new light in the bike. Motherfucking light is so tiny. I said, what are you actually lighting up?
Check out my horn.
Oh, that's sad. I need to get Teeter a horn for Teeter.
Oh, I like when you had the horn in the other studio.
That'll be for the new year. You're getting one custom made.
New year going to be bananas.
Custom made horn. All right.
All right, so we want to get the show going? Let's start.
Yeah, I'm trying to find a phone number real quick. Hilarious. It's Reach Around Radio. The phone lines are open, 323-522-5482. Call us up, and we're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back.
Reach Around Radio. Call me an old.
Hey, yo, I'm standing at the bar with a Cuban cigar.
It's Reach Around Radio. It's your boy Speed Doggy Dog in the house. Ladies, if you're having a little problem getting stuff for your kids, get at your boy Speedy. I'm Speedy Claus this week. Yeah.
I'm the poetess.
Yes, you are.
It's your girl Claudia Jordan.
TDP, Mr. 123 Knox, baby.
And it's the most ignorant with the least pigment. It's the white boy RT in the building.
And once again, Club Fluffies is back open. Your boy is the proprietor.
Who? The pie eater.
The appropriate eater.
TDP's working the coat check roll.
And it's going down, Speedy. We have 9 hangers left, and the valet is cracking, so I'm on my job. And the hot dog machine is working.
All right, cool. Yes. What drink specials do we have this evening?
You know, we still got those delicious Hennessy chewables.
Oh. No, those are gone. I already got them.
Those are delicious.
DJ always break them off with that Christmas special.
This is the song I was talking about, Claudia.
Can someone let Pam in, Sonny?
For what?
This is for that song.
You feel hard as hell, don't you, right now?
Yeah, it's a gangster Christmas.
Yeah, bitch, you ain't getting shit.
And I gotta give a shout out to Tremaine Fulton, who's watching us live right now.
Appreciate it.
Got a shout him out.
Tremaine.
So?
Right, cool, he in jail? Where he at?
No, he's watching us live.
Cool.
Lights out.
You see all these titties around us? It's happening. I'm gonna grab one of these before the show's over with. Somebody call
Are
in.
Are we at Club Fluffies or what?
Mm.
Yeah, that's why we grab a titty. In Club Fluffies, right. I go around and grab titties.
Okay.
You gonna let it happen?
No, we're not doing that. Speedy want to get creep, the shit slapped out of him.
I love how your titties have a sixth sense. It's yeah. Like as soon as the hand got close, you
warning,
like,
warning.
You see her face, it's like, motherfucker.
Nipple alert, warning, warning.
Someone is within a 2-foot radius.
And it ain't cool.
We have a special guest in the
very
house.
Very special.
Yes, indeed.
She's hung out with us before. Mm. The very beautiful.
Luxurious.
Kathleen Bradley, actress, model, and now author.
Author.
She and better known book. As Miss Podcast.
Has a new book coming out called Backstage at the Price is Right.
Yes. Mm.
Please welcome Miss Kathleen Bradley.
I sure will.
Yes. Hello, hello. It's a pleasure to be back here. I had such a great time the last time I was on the show.
You was off the chain.
You know, I just like being able to be here because, you know, it's a little different. I can say and do what I want
yes,
to do.
Yes,
just
say what
be
you
me
say.
And let my hair down. This is my hair.
Yes,
no,
it is.
This is my hair.
Oh, and you were a fan favorite. They talked about you for a long time.
Oh, they did.
Yeah.
Girl, they love you. My husband said, girl, did you say that? Did you say that?
Yes,
he
I
knows
did.
Me well enough to know. I will say anything.
He got his hands full with you, though. You must keep the marriage spicy, though.
Oh, he... He loves me. Uh-oh. He's 8 years younger than me.
Oh, okay. So I like it.
You know, I was able to, I don't want to say train him because it'd be mad.
You
don't want to hear that. But I did have to teach him some things after his first marriage. He was actually married to Bernadette Stannis from
what?
Good Times. That was his first
Thelma?
Wife.
Thelma?
Okay. Mm, Thelma.
This motherfucker back in 1,000. Shit.
Now he is.
Now he
now
is.
Now he is. Okay.
So you guys have a pretty active sex life?
Well, my husband and I.
No, the other dude. What the hell?
Do you bring rice-a-roni in the bedroom?
You know what? I'll say this about that. Right now, the older we get, we find more joy in just relating to each other on a level. But and we play a lot of golf. That's our foreplay, playing golf.
So you guys on 69?
No, we don't. We don't.
I used to have
Kathleen, I can see you being so off the chain.
I don't even like 69. I want to focus in on one thing or the other. I want to either do you, you do me. I don't.
I like how you pointed
like
at me.
I like to feel it when that's happening to me. And when you're doing 69, you're so concerned about pleasing the other person. Everybody's trying to compete to please everybody, each other, rather.
Okay.
Boy, it depends everybody.
Right. Can you do me one favor, though? So, you speak a little slower, please.
Okay.
I can see you being like a firecracker. Like, I can see you being so, like, a sexual, you know. Just,
I have so many different...
And you're a young guy, so.
I have so many different sides to me. Girl, I am Dr. Jekyll and Mrs. Hyde, mm-hmm. You know, and I will...
Shit, I'm
going to
do them.
Bring in that other bitch.
I never forget when I first met you. Like, it was me, you, Nikki Zarin. You put your leg up in the air. You had leather pants on. You licked your own thigh.
And yes, I
was like, that. That's my girl right there.
I know.
Can we take a bathroom break? I need about 5 minutes.
That's all I can think of,
right? Yeah. Oh, I'll get done quick. Really quick.
Yeah, people do
Price is Right. Price is Right.
And that's one thing, since we were on the show, Price is Right, we never were able to really fully speak or talk. You don't really know the people, models. You kind of, models, you kind of see them, perceive how they might be. But, you know, when we get a chance to talk and
what,
do things.
So what's the book about, basically?
Now look at this.
Yes, this is not this.
This is like a.
Who's that on the front cover?
You see this?
Mm-hmm.
Zoom in now.
It's right here.
Zoom in, boy.
This is my book, Backstage at the Price is Right: Memoirs of a Barker Beauty, and it deals with the 10 years I was on the show as the first African American model, and from 1990 to 2000, and of course, Claudia, she's.
And you guys didn't really talk much. You just did that.
No, we didn't talk much. We had fun, and Bob did allow us to talk. And,
and
as a matter of fact, when he was having sexual relations with Diane Parkinson, he was happy, happy, happy. We was happy Bob was getting laid, honey, because he used to, you know, be happy and let us talk and do a few things out of the ordinary. Mm-hmm. But when that all changed and stopped, it was a whole different
Wait, how come
he's like 90 now, right?
He is 90.
How come y'all weren't allowed to talk? Like, what happened with that? Like,
well, we were initially, but after that happened with Diane, he just shut down. He was mad at everybody.
He took the camera time. He took the
what
voice
did she do?
Away
ended
the
up suing him, or what happened?
She was going to go. She was going to sue him for sexual harassment, and she knew it wasn't right. She befriended me actually because she and Holly and Janice, who were the other long-standing models on the show, they did not like Diane. They did not get along. And so I came along here. I'm a nice little black princess, and she's like leading me around and helping me out doing things, which was fun. I was having a good time and all naive. I didn't want to get in the mix when I found out about it, but she shared a lot of things with me.
Wow.
Are they in the secrets. Book? Are they in the book?
Uh-huh, in the book, as a matter of fact.
Did you put the thing about Smokey Robinson in
the
book?
Uh-huh,
okay,
it's in
good,
here.
Good,
and,
okay.
You know, at some point, maybe during
Smokey
the show,
Hill?
I
want to
read a few excerpts.
Yeah, okay. Remember last time she said he had a book?
Said what?
Oh,
yeah, I wrote it in here. Well, actually, Diane said, "Oh, Kathleen, you know, I've dated so and so and such and everything, and Smokey Robinson, Tim Reed, and a couple other people. You know, she was sharing all the black men she'd been with.
The first Kim K.
And she said, but Smokey Robinson, oh, he was so big. She said he was probably the biggest man I've been with. And you know, she said it was so just so much, so overwhelming, and everything. She's telling me all this.
He gave her tears of a clown.
Yeah, baby.
Won't you cruise with me, baby?
But I said, you know, she went on and on, but I was like listening. I said, but little did Diane know, she didn't have to tell me how big the old Smokey Dokey was, because I had encountered the old Smokey Dokey many years ago in the old town days.
Wow.
But I didn't tell her that.
Oh,
so, but I said she must have liked the old Smokey Dokey because she kept going back for more.
So you were like, I hit it first type of thing.
Paul Mooney made a joke about Bob Barker.
But a whole bunch
didn't
of people hit it.
But
yeah. Smokey, I'm talking about, not me. Well, in that too, but I'm not saying that shit in the book.
Paul Mooney made a joke about Bob Barker getting his penis sucked every day.
I heard.
He did.
Yeah,
right.
he did it on one of his albums. Right. The old Bob was getting his.
He surely was. We were happy Bob was getting laid. Diane would go down with her robe down in his dressing room during the break. She'd come back up all happy, knocking on the door and stuff. Ooh, I said, where have you been? She started smiling and everything, and I knew where she'd been. I said, Diane, did you go to lunch, girl? You got a little bit of yogurt left.
Oh,
now, some yogurt, huh?
You got some of the Showcase Showdown on your mouth.
Yeah, let me start.
You know what? So this had to be in the time, because Bob did kind of change, even with the guests. He was really short with people. He really wasn't having fun with them, and they would be like, so then if they start jumping too much, he would move.
He was friendlier with dogs.
You know, but yeah, it did. Actually, that was the whole turning point with Bob's personality going sour, because Diane, and that was the first time he had ever had anything to taint his all-American personality.
Right. We didn't know he was getting it like that.
Nobody knew he was getting it like that. And she tried to say it was sexual harassment, which it really was not.
No,
she knew better. Everybody in the whole area within the Price is Right realm.
Did she get paid?
No, she did not. She had to drop it. But they offered her a nice little severance package, retirement package. And also, you know, she'd done Playboy a few times. And that put a whole nother connotation on the models and viewers in terms of viewing her and being able to look all up in her little stuff.
I
say, damn, that's a mark of beauty. You know, you've seen the whole Raw, all of what we're not supposed to be showing, and we're supposed to be like the girl next door types and all American and everything. So the producers and people weren't happy with that either.
Right.
So her days were numbered.
And Phil was there when you were there, right?
Yeah, Phil Wayne.
That's who I had my issue with.
I remember. I was cool with Phil.
And who was Phil? What did Phil do?
Phil Wayne, he was one of the producers. No, he's Italian, but Phil was kind of fresh.
Busy little hands.
He was fresh. There were several men and people
on that
show.
He was an asshole, though.
Now, is those kind of guys, the ones that kind of like put their hand on your back and go down like that?
Phil was like,
Claudia, I'm going to whack you off.
Here's the thing, like, you can't grab my ass and be an asshole to me. You gotta pick one. So if you're gonna grab my ass, you can't be cussing me out for being 2 minutes late. So if you're gonna think you're gonna get away with grabbing my ass, you gotta let a nigga slide on me a couple minutes late.
Literally grab your ass.
So did you say, actually, Claudia, because I did hear some things that you were late on occasion and that they were
seconds.
A little upset about that. But did you say something about Phil would go into the green room and set the clock 5 or 10 minutes ahead of time?
The security told me that.
So would appear that
the most I was ever
on
late
on real CP time.
The most I was ever late, and I do have a problem being late, but on that show I didn't want to lose that. The most I was ever late was 4 minutes.
Oh, really? Okay.
Just arriving, not to the show, nothing like that. And one time he took me in Bob's dressing room, he locked the door, and he was cussing me out. He was pointing at my face, spitting when he was talking, And that was after he grabbed my ass. So I'm like, oh, hold up.
Right.
I didn't sell you out when you grabbed my ass, but yeah. Now I
can't
will.
Spit in my face.
And then he really threatened me, like, I Whoa. Fucking made you type of attitude. Mm. Right? And he was swearing
wow,
at me.
There was a lot going on.
No, there was a lot going on there.
It was a lot. It's in the book, by the way, too, and there's some
is
nice...
Is it available
nice
now?
It is available on my website.
What's so, that?
Funny you should ask. KathleenBradley.tv. Kathleen with a K, KathleenBradley.tv. Go to my website. It will be on Amazon very Good. Soon and Barnes & Nobles. And it should be out this week, the real deal. This is my little put together that they sent me, which is nice. I love it. There's some great photos in here.
Nice. Yes.
I am so happy. It's been a labor of love for 7 years.
There's no pictures in it, Speedy. You can't tell.
Well, Kathleen, we're about to get into our Hot Topics. You want to hang out with us?
You can't get rid of me if you wanted to.
It ain't like you been a fuck.
It's about that time.
I'm certainly not doing 69.
Well, she will. This one over here.
34 and a half.
Look at her.
Oh!
I'll bid on that.
What up, Tina?
And got a little bitty legs up. Got a little bitty leg. That monkey's all out.
Got a little bitty legs up. Got a little bitty legs
that
up.
That monkey's all out.
Damn monkey back there.
In okay. Coochie news.
In Coochie news. Actually, this is Coochie news.
This just wow. in your coochie.
Johnny Orris, which is almost like Johnny Morris without the M.
Hilarious.
Died on Thursday, hours before he was supposed to redeem his prize from the Howard Stern show called Get My Grandpa Laid.
Mm.
So he had actually won a contest to get laid at the Bunny Ranch.
And he died.
And he died literally hours before he was supposed to hit it. Wow. And he died choking on a piece of steak.
Wow. What, in $2 Vegas steak? What is he thinking?
He didn't have the right meat in his mouth.
He's
a keeper. He was She's trying to get one of them fur burgers and end up with steak, man. He went that chopped fur burger. Should have weighed it.
And not only one, he was supposed to have sex with two chicks. He won a date with two chicks.
It's probably better he died then instead of with the women.
Coming and going?
Hey, I asked for the clams.
So did somebody take his place, or they just like, he ain't coming?
That's it.
I don't know if anybody
took
his place.
I mean,
but
non-transferable.
Yeah. I bet he's in heaven going, this is not the Bunny Ranch.
So now's not the
What's
time
Sonny
to get stiff.
What's Sonny coming there? What is Sonny talking about?
Come on, Sonny.
I was going to say his grandson that won it for him ended up taking his place.
Oh, wow. How is he going to fuck? Hours before his...
Hey, my daddy just died, but... Is it cool?
Why not? He's still going to be dead. Shit.
Hey,
might
bring
as well.
Bringing him the biggest, thickest steak y'all got.
Damn.
Hey, you seen my teeth? You don't need them, granddaddy.
Oh, hey, wow. Bring some of that cow shoulder.
His grandson ain't shit. Wow.
I'm like a tongue.
Man claims a snake bit his penis while urinating at a public restroom.
Two ways
Where
to look at
that. Was this? What I want
This
to
was in
with.
Ghana.
Oh, well, there you have it.
A man.
Thank you.
What am I supposed to do? My dick is on the ground.
I see a snake in my dick.
Yes, he was.
Ways.
On the
a man in Ghana claims he was using the public toilet when a big black snake.
Oh, come on.
That was
bit him.
Boy.
Yeah, that was my friend Dontrell.
Oh, dude, get out.
The snake bit him on the tip of his penis.
Tip,
he
please.
Said the pain was so intense that he ran out of the bathroom screaming. He said at first he thought it was normal. So what, you had gonorrhea? If he thought the pain was
well,
normal?
Well, he's in Ghana.
But then he said...
Not far from Rhea.
But then he said he looked down.
I was trying to pass a kidney stone I was going to eat.
Then he said he looked down and saw the snake, so...
Hey. If it's a really big black snake, you didn't notice it when you pulled your dick out?
He thought it was shit.
I was so tired.
This one already.
Well, they said the bathroom was filthy, so he could have thought...
That's what he gets.
I was so tired of holding my dick, I had to lay it on the ground.
Now, did someone have to suck the venom out?
Really, that's the key. Where were all his friends when he needed them?
But here's the thing.
I don't like you that
well,
much.
I guess you're going to die, man.
Yeah, sorry. Speedy, you're going to die. You're going to die, Speedy.
Yeah,
I'm sorry.
Here's the thing. Every dude in here, when he said the tip, like, God, yeah, damn, what a tip. They just went the shaft.
Is that how big was he sitting down?
Yeah,
he
was in the bathroom? Maybe it was in the toilet.
I hope he wasn't
sitting down. Yeah,
because
you had to put
your shit. It's nasty over there. Yeah. Been there, done that.
Why is this shit moving?
Yeah, Claudia just talked about
how she was. That's terrible.
I know you were there.
That's terrible because the snake probably had AIDS.
I went there with my singing group, The Love Machine. We were all over in Africa and what have you. We performed at a stadium, and we had our bags and stuff, and we were in the room getting dressed and trying to find some light. We were, like, down with all the soccer players and everybody, mm-hmm. you know, mm-hmm. and trying to find our places, and everything. It was so dark in there and everything. So one of the guys came along. He finally turned the lights on. Roaches were everywhere, all over the
and they
damn
were big.
Place, girl. We was like, oh,
they had
Lord,
them big
oh
roaches,
my God.
Huh?
I mean, they were everywhere. As soon as that lights came on, we were like, we had our little bags. We were like trying to get dressed and zipping stuff.
Got a roach in my Gucci.
Shit, oh, hell yeah. But we danced real good. We did it. Woo-hoo.
Like Joe's apartment.
Joe's apartment.
Hey, Ms.
A woman stabs a man after not fixing her breakfast.
A woman stabs a man.
Stabbed a man for not having her breakfast ready when she woke up from
sleep. Was she fat?
Oh, he hit.
Was she fat?
It says a Texas woman is accused of stabbing a man in the arm with a screwdriver for not fixing her breakfast. Authorities charge Rosie May.
That's black. She black.
With aggravated assault with a deadly weapon, causing serious bodily injury. The man's injuries were treated at the hospital. He was released. She was furious after she woke up from a nap and there was no food waiting for her.
Well, we know who wears the pants in that relationship.
Wow. She's
probably Speedy, have you ever got mad because dinner wasn't ready?
No, if you don't make the bed up.
Really? Yeah, I don't like that.
Can't make the bed up.
You get mad though? I hate when the
like you can't. I can't. I won't hit.
It's
no
your
more.
Bed.
I won't hit no more. No, your job after I hit you and you go to sleep.
Ooh.
After I fuck the shit out of you, you gotta make my bed.
At least
wow.
That bed. But you have to change them sheets, don't you, baby?
She gonna change.
Well, that's right.
All right.
Well,
now.
You gotta change it then. I understand.
You can't.
But you might want to air it out.
Oh God, Speedy, oh, God. Stop it.
I don't play no golf. I'm just letting you know.
Four play.
I am the 18th hole. Right.
Speedy, are you so hitting 19th on? Are you hitting on Kathleen?
No, she's married. I can't tell me. I would.
If she was giving something, you would go for that. You
if
think
I was
you could last?
Bob Barker, I'd be like, oh, nice. She's beautiful. You are a beautiful woman.
Thank you so much. Like that's why Claudia took my place because she and I have much in common and from Ohio, too.
No.
What can we say?
No.
Went to school there, yeah.
No.
Yeah. Yes, you went to school.
And speaking of stabbing,
who said cleavage, Ohio? I haven't heard of that one. I like that. That's cute. That's very cute.
A woman stabbed her boyfriend because he would not stop listening to the Eagles.
The group?
I know
the
feeling.
Group.
The group.
Oh, the group. Oh.
I know the feeling because I used to date this guy. Mm-hmm. Whenever he would be mad at me, he would play Machiavelli over and over and over. And no, just the one song. One, two, three.
Come here,
Poet, is you gonna finish on it? No, motherfucker. One, two, three.
And I mean, he played it over and over and over and loud, just to annoy me.
You better cook right now.
And I know you so well. I know you gave him that stare. Porter has the dopest stare in the world.
What? Ice Grill.
Man, her stare is.
He was a thug. He was really.
That reminds me of the time. Once again with my singing group, The Love Machine. We were in Frankfurt, Germany.
Oh,
we were performing in Frankfurt, Germany. We had met these two German guys. They were airline pilots, what have you. Me and my other girlfriend,
okay.
Bernice, and they invited us over their house.
Would you like some of the Wiener Schnitzel?
Listen, they invited us over to their place.
That means shut the fuck up. Go ahead, Ms. Parker.
And they had some acid. Okay, so... It was like paper acid.
Fun.
We took some acid and we were just having fun and everything stories. Upstairs in their loft and what have you, dancing and having fun. The thing is, my girlfriend and I, we wanted to hear James Brown get on the good foot of some soul music, R&B, and they were playing the Beatles and all the Kiss and all that shit. It was like, we let them have their little say. We put James Brown back on. They couldn't stand James Brown, just like we couldn't stand like that.
How could you not stand James Brown?
I always remember that. You will always remember your acid trips if you ever had acid.
How does that make you feel? Oh.
Great. It's different kind. And back in the day, when I was back in that day, it was kind of a common thing.
When acid was pure.
It was pure, baby.
Yeah, it was acid, LSD.
But you have
Quaaludes.
To be, yeah,
barbiturates.
When you take acid, you have to be in a good mood when you take it because it elevates whatever mood.
The
you're
euphoria
in.
And yeah. everything. It's like ooh, the lights and everything are bright.
Yeah, don't be in the public.
You can't really find your way home, but you better, you know, should be somewhere stable.
Around friendly surroundings.
Don't take away your drive.
No. Oh no, no.
We did that. We couldn't find my girlfriend's house. We were at Maverick's flat. I was taking her home, but she was like right on 35th and Coliseum.
Yeah, you were right,
right around
the
corner, yep. And it was foggy. We could not find her house. We could not find the damn
she's on
house. Oh my God.
Yeah, I got lost in my own neighborhood one time on mushrooms.
You would do that.
I was like, where am I?
Who am I? Ooh, mushrooms. Right.
What is the meaning of life?
Mushrooms. Yeah.
Mushrooms is fine. It's the same. It's almost the same as the acid effect.
I haven't done it.
They bake it in like cookies and brownies out in New York.
Yeah, you can do tea. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Store owner pulls gay-away candy pills off the shelf.
What, gay-away?
Say again.
What? Candy pills.
So you suck your gay away? The candy? Is it like a sucking kind of?
Well, it was,
I don't understand.
Mm, girl, this shit is sweet.
I've been through 12 bottles already.
Gay away.
It was this like candy that they sold.
Is this
sold
Bishop Eddie Long candy?
They sold this candy at a store, and it was called Gay Away, the original gay pill.
Oh, look, I want some free biker shorts.
The product, which is actually candy, comes in a box promising.
Let me guess, it's made in San Francisco?
I don't know. It's in Canada.
Canada.
Okay. It's a candy that comes in a box promising to cure gayness.
Come gay away.
So some people, so a little girl bought the candy. She got it home. She was like, Daddy, what is this? And so Daddy complained. And so they had to take the candy.
What is it supposed to do?
Come here, eat this shit.
It's a novelty. It doesn't do anything. It's just candy. It's just a joke.
We got that in the country, only it's called fag away.
Oh, damn.
Shame on you. Those are cigarettes in Europe. They are cigarettes.
I'd like to smoke a fag, please. You don't mind?
Fag.
You know what? I like to light up a fag.
Yeah, that's what they do, yeah.
They open the bonnet.
Suck on a fag.
I like to suck on a fag if you don't mind.
Without a
thank
filter.
You, thank you.
Sometimes you blow.
No filter.
Sometimes you blow on a fag.
No, I don't mind if you watch. You can watch.
Pack of fags.
You got one more?
Bag away candy. Gay away. That is gay away. That's a real, like, who, like, how did that.
But somebody took the time to print it up, put it in the candy thing, put it in the box. Several
well,
of the stores.
Well, the store, yeah, the store was like, let's do it. Like,
is it
how
nuts
did they agree
it?
To do it?
No, it's signed off.
No, it will none of you, though.
It's candy. A couple more quick ones. A woman booby traps man's house after he kicked her out. A woman is facing felony and misdemeanor charges after she allegedly booby-trapped her ex-boyfriend's house. Now, what she did was she put rat poison in a coffee can.
Oh, goodness.
That's a good idea.
She severed his electric blanket cord under a mattress.
She did what?
And she peed in his mouthwash.
Wow. Oh! Baby, this mouthwash tastes a little tart.
I'm going to get this coffee and wash it down.
That'll learn you.
Get under my blanket.
Is this Listerine or Listerine?
Yeah. I mean, could you imagine?
Ooh, you're
right. Nigga just kicks you out.
Yeah, that's right. Trap? Well, you know, woman scorn will do pretty much anything. You know, she will.
What's the worst you guys have done over a scorn relationship?
I'm Parker.
What?
I was in the car with a guy. One time he pissed me off. We just went out to have a good time on a weekend, came back and things didn't go well and he wasn't talking to me. He was just acting crazy or whatever. And I was in the car, so I had him get out the car to get my belongings when he dropped me off. I had a magic marker and I wrote on his car and shit, I said, you motherfucking Jesus. I wrote on this and that. I did it real fast and wrote all on the front of his car, on the dashboard and everything. Then I got out.
He came outside. This bitch can't spell.
He was mad. Oh my God. And no sooner than I can get into my house, he called me up and stuff. I'm like, okay, hello. Thank you very much.
Wow.
He said, I got to get home. And he was married, though, anyway.
Oh.
So. I spelled his wife's name out.
Oh, shit. Hey, girl, how you spell Hagatha?
So, I know. I want her to see this shit. And I'm like, I'm going to walk around and tell you something. That's
crazy.
What you been doing?
Wow. Teeter. Hilarious.
Wow. You know where the 7-Eleven is around the corner from house, townhouse?
Louis Dix is calling you. Tell him
to
come on.
Hey, tell him to come on. Anyway, so I'm riding.
Somebody, go get Louis Dix. Yeah, he's downstairs.
So I'm riding with Justin's mom.
Timberlake?
Before Justin was here.
Right.
We get in an argument. My dumb ass, I'm in her car. Mm-hmm. We pull into the 7-Eleven. I'm like, anyway, bitch, you don't give a fuck what you do with your life. I get out the car, and I heard her car go in reverse. I said, don't turn around. They're going to be hard. Fuck that bitch. So I'm walking in, and the dude 7-Eleven went, your girlfriend is leaving.
I would have left your ass too.
I would have left your ass in
heartbeat. Like, this motherfucker.
I've never been that kind of girlfriend, though. No, when we were over, it was over. I didn't
normally
scratch
up
your car.
I wouldn't have done that kind of thing, but it was just
Claudia.
The timing seems so good.
You took back ribs over.
I never, no, I did not.
Time.
Oh, well, I did whoops.
Oh, come
that.
On with it.
There you go.
Come on.
I did.
Let it go.
You beat a dude up?
Yes, because I wanted to break out with him. And
in the red corner.
And he was going through some things. Like, so I stayed with him an extra year. So I was unhappy with him. And I had put up some money for him. Right? Mm. He owed me a lot of money. And then Christmas came around. He needed some money. I gave him money so he could, like, buy something for his daughter. Like, $1,000. Okay?
For his daughter or dog?
He already owed me, like, $25,000. His daughter. He already owed me, like, $25,000 of his investment. So, anyways, I had found out that he was fucking around with some little, like, ratchet, like, porn star chick. So, I told my homegirl, let's go for a ride. I had keys to the house. I walked in, and I should have been arrested for what I did to him. I whipped his ass. Like, I didn't know I could hit that fast.
And he took it. He wasn't trying to hit back.
Well, first he put his hand, like, he grabbed my wrist, and then he put his hand, like, go ahead, hit me. And I was like, all right.
Okay,
oh,
bam. Got it in real quick.
Ear was bleeding. His nose. He was fucked up.
Good for you.
I fucked
this
shit up. I should have went to jail for that.
Damn.
But just think, if you stay with someone, you had their back.
That's
when
right.
they were at their bottom.
So
and you
love for money, Claudia.
You know what I mean? You have their back. You have their back, and then that person's like spending your money on the next chick or the next dude. I think that's very disrespectful. And
it
I would
is.
Expect
it
the man to do that to me
good.
If I did that to a man. Like, I'm going to spend some other guy's money on someone else. I think
that
that's
is cause for ass kicking.
So,
you did the right thing.
Well, that's
honey.
And the judge scores the bout 3-1.
Yeah.
Claudia.
Unanimous.
Jordan.
Unanimous.
My girl that I brought with me, she cried. She's like, it was. I felt so bad. She goes, I didn't know you could fight like that. But me neither. I was
remind me never to make you mad.
Yeah, really.
Well, that is it for
never do
funny
it
topics.
Hot topics.
Hot topics.
Ladies and gentlemen, lend me your ears. Miss Parker, you just going to take acid like that?
Who said that? That was back in the 70s.
Tears. Sports
70s.
Ticker right here on Reach Around Radio.
Too much
college. Jameis Winston.
Yes, Jameis.
Takes the Heisman Trophy winner. He runs away with it. Unanimous decision after all this stuff. We're trying to get him with the sexual harassment and all that and drop the charges. And this boy was took Florida State back to a level where they were when prime time Deion Sanders was there. So ranked number one. Florida State, congratulations to that young man for doing this thing. And in tennis, Serena Williams is going for number 18th major. She's going for history. Her and Roger Federer as well on the men's side are going for number 18 in the majors on the tennis court. And in NBA news, in the
Lakers
East,
ain't shit.
The Celtics are on top. I don't know. They don't have no names over there, but they're on the top. Over there in the Atlantic Division. Central, the Pacers are still on top.
Yeah, Pacers killing them.
Doing their thing. Miami Heat is representing the
Pacers
East.
Lost that.
Southeast doing their thing. And in the West, the Clippers, 16-9. They have Steven Jackson.
Yeah, just picked him up.
Put some more heart on that team. They needed that. Chris Paul can be the only one doing the thing. And in the Southwest, the Spurs, you know, they're always doing their thing. Tim Duncan. Is his marriage divorce final?
It should be, yeah.
I think
should
so, yeah.
Final? So maybe he'll go back to form.
Portland's on top.
Hey, Portland in that Northeast. They're doing their thing. And my mighty, mighty Lakers.
They ain't shit.
Kobe come back. Pau Gasol. If Pau Gasol and Kobe are not averaging 25 to 30 points.
You mean Pout Gasol?
Yeah, Pau Gasol.
They said he's going to get traded.
He might get traded. We need that. We can get that other boy from Portland.
Mm. Who? Yeah.
Aldridge or no. the other one?
No,
or
no, Batum. No, no. Have
Lillard. Aldridge or Batum? We yeah. need one of them boys.
You can have them too.
Or we can get Kevin Love from Minnesota. We can get somebody
Kevin Love
to do the thing. And in hockey, my Kings are in second place behind the Mighty Ducks over in Anaheim. And NFL, what can I say?
Uh-oh.
Great game.
2 weeks left.
Those Patriots, Claudia Jordan, her team.
They shit.
And four, that AFC just lost East. To the They lost to the Dolphins, but, you know.
I thought that was going to happen.
You felt that?
Yeah, all week I had a bad feeling about that game.
Okay, in the North, Cincinnati, 9-4. They're representing the North over there. Mm-hmm. And the South, Indianapolis, 9-5. They're doing the thing.
Falcons still got action.
No, they're horrible. They suck this year.
I feel bad for Tony Gonzalez.
Yeah,
he's
going to
retire.
Yeah, he came back because they had a nice
squad. And
he's
going to be on a 5-11 team.
Then y'all picked up Steven Davis.
Steven Jackson
from the Rams.
Yeah, too.
And then he got hurt, and then it was all Drano from there. And in the West, the Kansas City Chiefs and the Denver Broncos are representing over there. Peyton Manning got the Man of the Year award in sports. I think that was a fair situation.
Yeah, Peyton's having a hell of a year.
NFC East, those Philadelphia Eagles, Tayshaun, Lewis Dix, Ken Marshall, they still on top.
Tasha.
And
Tasha.
And
what'd you call him, Tayshaun?
Yeah.
Yeah,
they're going a little bit gayer than that.
And those Cowboys. Hysterical.
Those
Cowboys, 23-point lead at home versus the Green Bay Packers with no Aaron Rodgers. Mr. Flynn came down and served them some gin.
And Tony Romo.
He just
can't do it. He just can't do it.
That's horrible.
Facebook, know, Twitter.
He's winning by so much.
And Instagram ain't shit because they got jokes on
jokes
the
Cowboys.
They said, here's one.
Is that what happened?
What does Tony Romo and hookers have in common? Uh-huh.
They will never get a ring.
They went in on him.
They was killed.
I mean, it's terrible. The boy's got a $55 million guarantee. You in the most magnificent arena ever built, and you can't pull through over a quarterback that's not even on the radar like Matt Flynn?
Oof.
Are you serious?
They can't win two in a row.
Cowboy Nation, sorry to hear that. And that's Teeter Sports Ticker right here on Reach Around Radio.
Give us a call. The phone lines are open. 322-522-5482. And we're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right
back. Oh, shout out to Larry Fitzgerald. Yeah, he got a nasty concussion.
Oh, yeah.
He got knocked the fuck out.
Poor thing. We'll be right back, you guys.
Okay.
Like you owe your tax. Owe me back like 40 acres to black. Pay me back.
All right, shake let's like go.
Shimmy, shimmy, cocoa pop. Yeah.
Shimmy, shimmy, cocoa pop.
Shimmy, shimmy, cocoa pop. Shimmy,
shimmy, cocoa pop. Yo, it's Reach Around Radio. Yeah, it's your boy, Speed Doggy Dog. It's your boy, Speed Doggy Dog in the house for all the beautiful ladies out there that need Santa Claus in their life. I am Speedy Claus.
Santa Claus is white, according to Fox News.
That's right.
Well, you know black people don't like your cold like that.
That's true.
It's your boy Speedy.
I'm the poetess.
She's girl Claudia Jordan.
It's Teeter on Twitter.
And it's the white boy in the building, RT. What's up?
And Kathleen Bradley, a.k.a. Miss Parker. Miss Parker, how you doing?
Who turned your mic on?
Look at we have a full. What? We have a full house.
It's your boy. And don't forget, we got Club Fluffies is jumping off right now. It is the Christmas holiday. We'll come back to him in a second. Teeter, Coachette room should be filled by now, right?
Well, Lewis Dix just walked in and took the last hanger, so I hung up his little young jacket, and we're ready to party.
Yeah, the last member of the Ink Spots.
Wow.
Oh! Hold it there, young man. Don't you dare move. What drink specials do you have? That was funny as fuck.
I know.
Don't say shit till we get this in.
Last surviving member.
We have vodka-infused churro sticks.
I love me some Kathleen.
DJ Always. Break something off with the Ink Spots.
Oh, yeah.
It's Christmas time, bitches.
It was December 21st.
Oh, but hello, guys. Good to be here.
We still in a couple of them.
Oh, my God.
You can't talk
Ill reindeer.
Yeah, and I guess you can't get in either with all the fat women around, but I'll wait.
I'll sit.
Mm-hmm. No, you can get in. You skinny as a motherfucker. You dodge raindrops, motherfucker.
Slide. Slide.
It's Reach Around Radio. It's your boy, Speedy.
Go ahead.
We have very special guest, Louis Dix. What up, LD?
I haven't seen you on your walk, buddy. You look great. You look great, Tan. I heard you've been out doing your thing. Congratulations.
She's been in Africa.
She's pregnant.
Speedy, I still understand you're still being babysat by
a
nanny.
A houseboy.
Yeah, so welcome. I hear you're the nanny of the house, but that's a good thing. It's a good gig. You get a nice car, gas. Hey, I'm with you, man. You get a gas card yet? Because I went and looked Jamie's stuff on taxes. Public, your name was on there.
Wow. You're
Speedy
dependent? Call up.
That's right, all day long. He's the first one, too.
He's the Manny.
Yeah, but Manny. It's good to see you. Your boys are doing well, I'm sure. You got the Panthers on. That's cool. Poetess, is always nice hearing from you.
Thank you.
You look great. T, we've been working together.
Yes,
so
sir.
Been there you cool. Go. And RT,
how are you, Lou? How are you,
Lou? A lot of good things. Pam, happy birthday.
Thank you.
And Nappy, good to see you.
That's two.
Kirkwood 2, that's what I call it. And now to the young lady who said I looked ink spots. Now that was interesting because that was funny.
Yeah, first of all, I'm not a young lady.
That's true. I'll get
I'm
into that part.
Yes, lady.
I'll get to the dust part of you.
Oh, wow.
I saw you in Hunger Games. But listen, seriously, I think you're very talented.
I didn't either.
But I think you're very talented, and I'm sure you'll get some more work one day.
Lewis?
But you're still calling off Miss Parker.
Yeah.
It's time for you to get a new role.
Just work. You're right, so I'm for hire.
What'd you say? The Beijing is rubbing off?
Yeah, the Beijing did take on your.
Oh, that's all right.
Are you saying the Beijing is now in Thailand?
No,
you love our. You gotta let it stay a little bit longer.
No, I just didn't. I washed my face before I came, and I just didn't put it back on. That's
okay.
Cool. And I work Thursday, so I'll be just for men Thursday. So,
where are you working at?
I'm sure she won't be there because it's a young show. But I like her. You fine in one day. You fine, man.
She fine now. Yeah. Get into it.
I'm keeping it together.
Yes, you are, my love.
By any means necessary.
Don't forget, you can pick up Kathleen's book, Backstage, at The Price is Right.
Oh, that's right. www.kathleenbradley.tv.
Let me do a little Price is Right modeling. Hold on.
There you go.
Well, get your fingers off
her
breast.
She never shows a high belt.
Oh, yeah, I'm going to get that.
What's the proper way to hold it? Show them. If you were
like this.
Wow.
And you have to tilt it down a little bit because the glare of the light, and that's always something that we would talk about.
See, I don't know any of that.
Okay.
Now, can I ask how old were you on that picture?
Pardon?
How old were you on the picture?
I just took this a couple years ago, baby.
Oh, okay. All right.
You know, you'll be surprised what lighting will do.
Right.
And
What was that, Louis 6?
It won't work on Louis.
But no, this picture I did. Actually, I just took a couple years ago. Griff Griffin took it, a friend of my photographer. This is actually taken at the townhouse. Thank you very much.
Oh,
it's more recently me. But you know, there are people who have baby pictures and shit on the front cover of their books. So, you know, hi. Yeah, whatever the hell I want.
You have won so far with that ink spot job.
Let the people of America know where the townhouse is.
I'm done with
it. It's on Crenshaw.
La Tierra.
You know the Cork?
That's
cork
our two. Spot.
Oh, yeah, we know the Cork.
Yeah. We used to hang at the Cork.
Okay.
Yes. Greasy Spoon. Greasy Spoon. I know you would know it.
Go ahead, Louis. What are you saying?
It's not about it's totally off subject. My seventh grade team got beat by Brentwood 64-20 today.
Okay. Sports. That was earlier.
I hate him. Why?
So that has put you into a funk?
That's a bunch of white boys that beat you guys. Yeah.
And we have
Europeans.
A couple celebrities
let
out there.
The good
their sons
roll.
Are on the team. I'm not going to call them out, but you need to stop being a celebrity and get in the backyard with your son.
Wow.
He got beat down.
Who are you talking about?
What celebrities?
Come on, you don't never hold punches. Come on,
tell us.
Couple of them are filmmakers.
John Singleton. Spike Lee.
No, Spike Lee's son wouldn't have no game.
Tyler Perry.
And I've seen
John. Tyler doesn't have a son. Look at
Carl Franklin.
You're doing a great job leading the cheers.
F. Gary Gray.
You're flipping as
Oh, F. Gary Gray.
Somersault.
Keenan. Is it a Wayans out there?
That's close.
Oh,
got to be other one. Team.
All right, anyway, so what? Pam, good to see you. Is your birthday coming up?
Happy birthday.
Take the white boy's mic.
When is Friday?
Oh. Are you getting fucked that day?
I doubt it.
Aww.
You doubt some mechanical problems. I doubt it.
Oh,
what the hell?
Wow,
Pam.
So always with the plumbing girl, with the plumbing.
Wait.
Something wrong with the couch?
The couch is in the shop.
It's getting reupholstered.
Wow.
In January.
Yeah, that's right. Never heard that.
Wow.
But really, she's going to need you guys to come check on her. And, you know.
I plan on coming.
No,
to check on her.
No.
No. I'm going to give her some.
Just because I'm out of town, no.
You'd be surprised what's happened since you've been out of town.
You ain't fucking Pam.
She's a cock blocker. She's a cock blocker.
Blocking cock all day.
Speedy Plus, you're spoken for now.
Oh, you got a girl?
Oh.
What do you mean you got a girl? He's been having a girl.
I didn't know
you got a new
that.
Kid?
He's just now
a new
claiming
her. Facebook. He said me and my girl.
Oh, well, congratulations,
Speedy. I must have missed that. Mm, okay.
Which chunky?
Oh, really? Wow.
Speedy. Really?
Did you see on Facebook?
I didn't see it.
There was an announcement with think, trumpets and everything.
Wait. Let Pam said, wait. Pam said, Speedy, really?
I've seen that face before in my life. Just like,
really?
Pam, this bitch came over here, really?
Hold on, let me find a picture.
Oh, that's a new one.
Oh,
girl?
They trying to bust you off for real.
What made you commit, Speedy?
Me and my girl.
Was it just weight? The weight was too much?
What made you lose weight? Cancer?
Oh, no.
Oh, wow.
Well, you can kill me all you want, but you keep staying fat. You'll die first.
No.
That's what kill me about you little fat people running around.
Apparently not, Louis.
You fat people running around thinking y'all healthy. Watch. Something going to catch y'all. That's why they want everybody to have Obamacare. They got something they gave to y'all. Y'all eating at Chipotle and Starbucks. All that stuff going
to
kill y'all. Anything on the dollar menu.
You
know you've been
anything on the dollar menu.
Anything on the dollar menu going to kill you. That's why they want everybody to have Obamacare.
No, that's real talk. I went to a fast food place. I'm at the drive-thru, and now they have
that
notices.
That will remain Burger King.
No, it's actually McDonald's. They have signs on the drive-thru windows now warning you that the food may cause cancer.
You have to
really?
Eat on top of the stove, because everybody's my wife, you you eat on top of the stove, you eat green, the leafy, you have your stuff go, and you eat oatmeal. You chunky people, I'm telling you. No, you don't. It goes right there. You don't eat nothing near oatmeal. It's got steak and something, some cheese and something mixed in there.
Can I have some?
But he's a vegetarian.
Oh, are you?
He's a scary terrier.
Can I have some melanoma nuggets? Can I get the benign burger to go wrap that up?
And a seaweed shake.
Sweetie, you gotta stop saying you're a vegetarian.
I never said that. She said that.
No,
you said
that. You don't
that
eat meat.
That was
a
long time
you
ago.
You eat pepperonis, beef jerky,
that was
chicken
long.
Pepperoni is not a meat.
Oh, it's from the pepper family.
That was a long time. That's over 2 years ago now.
Are you happy?
Very happy. Y'all gotta get away from this. It's 2 years ago.
Wow.
Moving on.
Well, I was recently at Michael Carrier had a party, and they had... He has all his little people doing different things and what have you in the living room. And one lady stood up and she said, you know what, we must connect. We must learn to reconnect with our bodies and raw vegetables because it's all connected now. We indulge and eat all of these good foods for our body. Mm-hmm. And then one of the other young ladies stood up and said, you know, health, you have to work out. You really must maintain a good, healthy diet. And it's good for your soul and your mind and everything.
Now, that's what I'm saying. That's an ex-crackhead party.
No, but, you know, really, and I listened to them. I really thought that, you know, they have a lot of meaning. And, you know, my mind was like, you know, I really almost went and poured out that glass of Hennessy I had. But I didn't. Yeah, they never convinced me, but they had some truth to the matter.
You just played a horse twice?
I had a question for y'all.
No.
No, this is good. After I thought when Mandela
Wait,
died.
When Mandela died. Segment.
I don't care. When Mandela died, my thing was, who do you think could have died 2 days and knocked him off the map?
I don't know who, Louis.
Who do you think? T had a good one.
Muhammad Ali.
Yes.
No.
Yes. Yeah.
Somebody said Beyonce.
I say
like,
Prince.
No.
Oh,
you say Prince.
Definitely.
Prince.
All of them.
To make world leaders. What world leader is going to go to Beyonce's funeral?
No, Obama.
Beyonce is love. Beyonce is love. People worship her like she's God.
People
love her.
Yeah, she's taking over Michael Jackson.
Yeah, she is.
Mm-hmm. But who would go, what world leaders do you think some of them would go to their funeral?
Oh, in terms of world leaders, you're right.
Well, as far as leaders, I mean, who else? Muhammad Ali, you know they're going to go.
Not on that level.
On Ali, who else?
So what is the question?
Britney Spears.
The question is who?
Is there an answer to it?
Yeah, well, I think the answer, well,
didn't
if you guys
hear the
would
horns,
think.
Motherfucker, we had horns.
No, I don't have headphones.
Okay.
Oh, we're going into a segment. Damn.
New people on the show.
And it's Louis Dix coming around the backstretch. He keeps talking. He won't shut the fuck up. He wins it.
Okay, let me tell you. You called me. I didn't call you. I'm trying to help your ratings.
I called you.
I'm trying to help your ratings.
Girl.
I saw your ratings. Wow.
Our ratings just plummeted.
Down to two.
That sound can only mean one thing.
What's that?
It's time for our game show.
Which
what
one?
Game
show?
Let Louis keep fucking up.
Guess what race?
God
Damn.
And he tried to interject again.
And crack is running through his veins.
Shout out to Ricardo.
Cancer's is leading.
T. Fisher King and Aaron.
Fat cells are building up on Speedy.
Okay, so I'm going to read some news stories, and you guys try to guess the race of the person committing the crime. All right, here we go.
Here we go.
A woman is facing charges after allegedly trying to smuggle a marijuana pipe in her private parts into jail.
Pam.
A 25-year-old was arrested, accused of causing a disturbance outside of her home. When officers got the suspect to the jail, officials searched her and found a marijuana pipe in the woman's body cavity. According to the police, the pipe had a marijuana and fish odor coming from it.
Oh, God.
Who wanted to smoke salmon? Who wanted to smoke salmon?
No pun intended.
The loose lady is now facing charges for disturbing the peace and trying to bring contraband into a jail. Guess what race?
Amanda Bynes.
Poetess.
I'm gonna say white on that one.
White. Yeah, that's a white activity.
Yeah, because if it was black, they would have smuggled crack.
No. Hysterical.
She said what?
Like I said if they were black, they would have smuggled crack, not weed. No. I say white.
White?
Speedy?
I'm going to say white big girl.
Big white girl.
That's your
big
specialty?
Bertha. You're saying Bertha smuggled some weed in there?
Big white girl smuggled the weed in. Yeah, big white girl.
The fishy smell kind of threw me. I don't mean stereotypical. This is a sister.
Oh! Oh! She's a sister.
Who wanted the soul fish? Filet of soul. Filet of soul. Anybody?
See ya.
I'm going to go European on this one.
European? Why is that, Peter?
Because Europeans smell like fish.
And wet dogs.
And wet dogs. Okay. Pam, you want to hop in since your vagina's messed up right now?
What's going on? Really? What's wrong with your shit?
Wow. I mean, really?
You already said it. You already said you're getting surgery.
Since the fish market shut down?
Hilarious.
You already said the cartoon.
I'm saying Asian.
Asian.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Because they like fish and they go to, you know, the fish
they
markets
like
downtown
fish.
And everything.
They like dogs,
fish
too,
when they say she means coochie fish.
I know she meant
that. Yeah. Oh, okay.
What's wrong with your shit?
She said it's being reupholstered.
Who ordered clam chowder? Who ordered the clam chowder?
Hey.
I think it was,
a little early on
look, it's not a white person because we're kind of crafty like that. We'd be like smoking like the bed bunk
get
or an
it,
apple yeah. or, you know, we'd figure out some way to smoke the...
So you're above crack pipes.
Yeah, I'm just, yeah,
okay,
we don't
see.
Have to smuggle the, you know, we're not trying to smuggle that in our vagina.
Yeah, but
so.
Meth is an old
I'm going, yeah, meth, we smoke meth, we don't need,
So you're going?
I'm going to go African-American.
Black, okay.
Yep.
Kathleen Bradley.
Well, first of all, we know that the prisons and jails are highly populated with Hispanics and blacks. There are very few white folks up in there. Okay, tell the truth, Judge. So I am really going to flip the switch and say probably with some fish taco bitch came in. Hispanic!
I got your peppers.
Your pipers.
Latino.
Guys, we're doing a fucking show.
I picked the piper.
Nadia, go ahead.
I picked the piper.
But she asked to do
I think
okay,
so.
Okay,
really.
She's not that the woman. Yeah. Niggas, calm down. The woman who stuffed the pipe in her pussy was a 25-year-old white woman.
Oh. Oh. I was right.
Damn, Bowens was right.
She really got a smoke. That is crazy. Okay. She really has a smoke.
Next. I know I ain't smoked in 3 days.
Oh, I'm not talking about you, but if you do, okay.
Okay, police. Ready? Can I have my music, please? Police say they found 20 pounds of marijuana in boxes wrapped as Christmas presents inside a minivan after a traffic stop.
Can't pull this out.
A 38-year-old man faces felony drug charges after the stop. Police say they became suspicious after the man was stopped and they got him to agree to a search.
Mm-mm.
They say they found 20 pounds of weed vacuum sealed inside large boxes wrapped as Christmas gifts. Online court records say he was taken to local jail and a defense lawyer was enlisted. Guess what race?
I'm going to have to go with Mexico's on that one. I say Mexican.
I haven't heard that in a while from you. Sweetie?
Yeah, because he agreed to get searched.
That's a white
probably don't speak English.
But if
sure, you could look. So.
But if you don't agree, but they can still...
Eventually.
Well, they got to get a warrant.
Yeah.
So you can...
So you could, but trust me, they're going to scare the shit out of you. They're going to bring them dogs.
Legal.
Once the dogs come, it's a wrap.
But you're on to something.
Mexican.
Lou Dix.
I'm gonna just start doing this. Get out of here. Check the car. Yeah, not my car. No, no, not my car at all. Yeah, he's Mexican. Because the brother can't get that seal wrap going. He broke that machine.
That sounds kind of whitish. Oh, Peter.
Uh oh.
Rap.
Detective TDP.
I'm gonna go Tony Montana.
Tony Montana.
Tony Montana. Tony Montana.
Alex.
All right, Pam.
I'm gonna go white on that.
White. Why do you say white? The seal wrap.
Yep,
that is tough to do.
That's a pussy, bro.
Yeah, well, exactly what I was gonna bring up was the it was vacuum sealed. That is a trick the Caucasians use for the drug trade.
Right.
And we feel like we can get away with anything, so we would grant the search. Right. So I'm gonna say cracker on this one.
Cracker.
Miss Kathleen
well,
Bradley.
Obviously, you guys are missing the whole point here, and I'm going to flip the switch on ya.
Uh-oh.
And it was absolutely a Jewish man.
Oh, God.
Because he could say, we have Happy Hanukkah, and I don't know how the hell this shit got in my car.
Hello. Okay. Adam Feinstein.
All right. Yeah. The man that was giving pot as presents was a 38-year-old Colombian man.
Oh. Mexican, Colombian.
Latino.
Hey, Peter got it.
Peter.
Did you say Colombian?
He said Tony Montana.
Tony Montana.
Oh, okay. That's
Happy
Cuban.
Hanukkah.
That's Cuban, yeah.
I have last one here.
Tony Montana. Tony Montana.
After the owner of a grocery store was robbed by a man at knife point, the suspect was busted after police simply followed his snowy footprints back to his house.
Damn snow!
The victim was locking up the business for the night when he noticed the suspect in his truck. The suspect reached into the victim's truck and took a briefcase. When the owner confronted the suspect, the suspect pulled out a knife and called the police. Officers then followed the footprints, the only ones around, in the snow, and located the suspect, who was taken into custody. He was charged with aggravated robbery, obstructing official business, and possession of drug paraphernalia.
And being stupid.
He also had a roll of money belonging to the victim. Guess what, Mace?
It wasn't me, it was a Sasquatch.
I'm going to say white.
Whites. Yeah. Why whites?
Bold, this has brazen. Just a white feel to
white
it.
White feel to it.
I got an easy answer to that. Okay. Definitely white because he ran home.
Didn't go to the club.
Didn't go to the apartment. Didn't go to his mama's house. He went home.
Didn't go to his homies.
I'm going to say black.
Yes.
Because he didn't look behind him to see his footprints.
Wow. Okay.
Oh. And why are you here again?
Who does?
Shit. I thought you were supposed to bring something to the show.
That was deep.
Okay. You said that was deep.
Yeah, what was deep was the footprints.
Right.
This part?
This Peter.
I'm going to go Nubian on that.
Okay.
I was going between black and Mexican, but I'm going to go, shut the fuck up, Speedy. I'm going to go black on that.
Black. Okay.
Well, I think the we all know what the preferred weapon of the Hispanics is, which is a knife. I'm going. I'm going Hispanic on this one.
Oh, wow! Okay. They do love cutlery.
They do like the Ginzu 2000.
Miss Puck.
Well, you know, you read part of that story, but they didn't tell the whole truth about it. Actually, it was Stevie Wonder's icing dog going home and trying to get some goodies for the Woof Pack.
Okay. That's a good one.
All right, you're going dog.
This Parker, I'm seeing the side of you. I've never seen it. Yeah, it ain't funny.
Actually, the robber is actually from your state, from Ohio, from Akron, Ohio.
Of course. Oh, okay, that's what we do.
The robber who forgot to cover his tracks was a 48-year-old black man from Akron, Ohio.
Oh, yeah, Akron.
I am so disappointed.
Who trained Stevie Wonder's dog?
Get in the game, Mexicans. Get in the game. No, I said I'm
happy as hell.
Wow, nice surprise. This has been another edition of
Guess What Race.
I forgot I'm doing the horn.
It's a remix.
You guys, it is our last show of the year.
2013. No, bye.
We no call up tonight?
No call.
No, ain't nobody calling.
Yeah, we have a call.
Lewis.
I'm sorry. Caller, what's your name and where you're calling from?
Yo, what's up? I can't tell you my name. I tell you where I'm calling from. Harlem World. Harlem on the Rise. What's up?
What's up, dog?
Hey.
Why you can't say your name?
Everything good. Everything good. Because I called in because this is Claudia Jordan's baby father.
Okay. It's Mr. Nut.
Are you the one that she's been bringing lunch to work to every day?
Hilarious.
Yo, baby,
man. Exactly. I've been listening to the show all night, you know what I'm saying? She's been a new YouTube. You know, she might be a plus one, as somebody said on the show, but that's baby real.
You're about to be on the blogs.
And, I just wanted to call and confirm that that's real, that's right and exact.
Cool. Right and exact.
All right.
Are we going to name that baby? Who that baby there?
Thanks for calling. Thanks for listening.
Hey, you really called to just say that one? Wow. That's your rap?
You
need to listen to some Kendrick Lamar.
Yo, check me out, dog.
Let me see.
Claudia in New York now. I'm holding it down. She with a real G. They call them athletes and actors and rappers, all them fake G's that she used to be with.
Right, but Holmes, you call and putting that on blast. Any man with game don't have to call and say that. It's already written when you walk down with her. So you're showing a bit of softness that a man, real man, back up, Holmes, know the game. Are you working too hard for this?
No,
because we already know her intimately. We already know her intimately, not sexually. See, wait, Holmes, you don't know her the way we know her. So what I'm saying is that you got to earn yours. Now back up.
Yeah.
You don't act all, you got to back up and take baby steps. Because what you're trying to discover, Holmes, we already know. We know what kind of woman she is. She's a good woman. But you got a lot of work to do because she's actually had some great athletes that are paid and pay for private jets. You haven't done that yet, Holmes.
Yeah.
So with this phone call, anybody can call here. That ain't showing no game.
Oh, God.
That's right, LD.
Anyway,
and welcome to the Dix the Downer Show.
Anyways. Thanks for calling the show.
Yeah, thanks for
Pam, you got some scrabble bags to Pam for us.
Pam.
Hey, always hit that.
Pam, do me a favor, you get your pussy right and do your segment.
Shout out to Jay Cal, Alicia Wells, Derek Wallace, Jalen Cook, Nate, Rich, Carvel Robinson, and Roger Smith.
Carvel, I'm going to go black.
The name's Carvel. The name's Carvel.
With a...
Oh, shit. Scrambled eggs and Pam. Scrambled eggs and Pam. Scrambled eggs and Pam.
Get down, y'all.
I don't even
know
how to beat.
Scrambled eggs and Pam.
And everybody say it like Louis Dix.
Scrambled eggs and Pam, you bitch.
No problem.
He said over easy or over hard. Just flip it.
Hey,
quit
Nikki Pam.
Hey, Nikki Pam.
So I got actually two quick stories.
Is that your hair?
Huh?
Is that your hair?
You know what?
Okay,
Pam took
all,
a picture. Yes. Pam took a picture on Facebook and Instagram. Pam's real hair is down her back.
It's longer than this, FYI.
So where is it at now?
It's down her back. Pam's hair.
I want to keep protecting it and, you know, growing it a little bit longer in the front, actually.
Man, Pam's hair is...
I couldn't believe it,
like,
actually.
Back here.
Wow.
Yeah. Anyway.
Go ahead,
Superhead Stephen Strait punks Lil Wayne. I don't know if you guys saw the story, but who knew that they were in a relationship for 9
Superhead?
Months?
Superhead?
Yes.
Oh, wow. Yeah,
Lil
I did.
Wayne, for 9 months they've been in a relationship.
I know her.
You knew that?
I know her.
Oh, what you know about her?
I know a lot about her.
I'm scared.
Carry on.
Well, yeah.
Don't ask shit, bitch.
She experimented on me once.
Oh.
What?
I thought I'd get you all's attention with that one.
What?
Yeah.
So is she good at
what
she does?
Superhead? Superhead, Superbed.
Wait, what happened?
Oh, my.
She said she had sex with Superhead.
I didn't say that.
Or you said she went down.
I said she experimented. You see how y'all motherfuckers ain't listening?
Well, experimented
how I said she experimented on me. That could have been in the kitchen because, you know, she wrote a cookbook.
So are you saying she...
Hello, and she fixed me some food.
Are you saying she's 30? She 34 and a half, Jew?
I just said that. No, but I do know
she doesn't do 69.
No, but she does.
I tried.
And she's very much into cooking food as well. And
she cooked for you?
She experimented.
I better when the mic is in front of me.
She gave you
no food. See, there y'all have dirty minds.
No, first of all, you said it out there so we have dirty minds.
I know,
so
and I got y'all
yourself.
Were like Eve Hutton.
No,
like,
I don't think she
would.
No, she had some other people.
Okay, go with the story, man.
Okay. So I take that back. They were in a relationship for 5 months. I mean, 5 years.
5 years.
Yes, 5 years. So anyway, they got into it. Over text message, and so she says to him, "You're an icon, but you act like a newbie, and I can't be associated. You act like you don't know your worth.
you're mediocre, and basically you're a fucking loser. Oh, you're a fucking loser. I gotta read it because I was on my cell phone.
Use your finger.
You're a fucking loser. Come on. And you know you can do better. So then he hits her back with, shut the fuck up, it's war. I know, right? He kept it real, real brief. And so,
I went to college.
And he's like, she's like, I'll love you forever, but I'm 56, I'm gone. He's like, good, 56. Bitch. And that's, it's just like, who knew that they were in this long-ass relationship?
But he's fucking a couple of brides.
For years.
Who knew?
For years, actually.
And Darius was typing while all this was going on?
But he's been in relationships with other women.
But with her, though, too.
That's what I'm tripping off of. You know what I mean?
But you know, you always got to get that super head.
Wow. I don't know. I guess she just got turned off of something he did. And
we're going to, get a grant so we can go ahead and she can teach some people how to do that, so these women need to get some jobs and make some money.
Oh, shit.
Okay. Why not? Everything is out there. Everybody needs a job, no matter what. Why go pay a little cheap hoe when you get a super hood head? And
super hood head.
Best.
Super hood head.
I want to welcome you guys to the apartment.
There's grants out there for that.
She sucked my dick and robbed me.
There's grants out there. What's the next story, Cam?
Welcome to the Parker and Lou's Dick Show.
I guess there's a little tension. I mean, even though the tour just ended or whatever, between Kanye and Kendrick.
Already?
Yeah, God, I guess when he came to L.A., like, my boy works for the record company, and he's over Kendrick or whatever. But when he came to L.A., now, granted, they done been in many cities. He told him, now, he's from Compton.
Yes.
He couldn't have no comp tickets, right?
In L.A.?
In L.A., in his hometown, which is really fucked up. And so I guess that night at Soundcheck, at Soundcheck that day, the sound was messing up, and for some reason Kanye did not want him to shine. Now this is from my boy at the record company, right?
Wow.
So he goes to pick up some tickets, right?
I'm sure the Kendrick, record label bought tickets. He doesn't even need
Kendrick comps. Bought them for his people. Mm-hmm. So he bought like 40 or something like that. Because of course he had many, a group of people. So when he gets there and they're like, well, you're from the record company, do you want Kim Kardashian? She has 45 from Kanye.
Oh.
I know.
51-50.
He did.
Yeah.
So apparently, it was only a couple of days left. So he told him, he's like, look, man, he went off. They got into it or whatever. But he's like, I'm going to continue doing the tour. But, that just lets you know how crazy Kanye is. You know what I mean? Why have him on the tour if you're going to try to fuck him up? But I know it happens all the time.
Because you don't want him to shine it here because he home. So he going
You know he's going to kill it.
He probably Kendrick had all that Crips and Bloods.
Right, and Kendrick is that dude right now.
Yeah.
GQ, man, the year. He's on all kind of stuff right now.
Please tell me, you guys. So I know everybody, I don't want to talk about Breakfast Club, but please tell me how you guys saw Charlamagne go off on Kanye. Did anybody see that?
Amazing.
I only seen the one with him and Sway.
Oh, yeah, I saw that one, too. Yeah. But basically, Charlamagne was like, your shit's whack, your album's garbage.
What about Arsenio? Didn't Arsenio just get into it with Kanye?
Yes, he did.
Didn't he tell him to get the hell off the stage?
Uh-uh. Yep. Kanye is basically nothing.
That's what I heard.
Yeah, it came up in the segment.
I think I have you have to understand Kanye, what he's going through. When he lost his mother, he lost all structure.
I think so.
He really didn't have his father. There's no male telling him stop.
All his life, or
I don't know about all his life, but what I'm saying is that whenever a man starts going downhill, what stops you is another man, someone you respect, someone you love and care for. Say, hey man, look, this is what you need to do, and that's most of the time. I'm sure there's times when women have helped you, but it's obvious that Kanye West, because there's no strong male figure in the Kardashians at all.
True.
There is no male figure to just pull him aside and say, hey, listen, man, you're not being a man. You're not being a decent man.
Right.
And most young men have to be taught how to become decent men and learn their character.
Charlamagne certainly told
him. And right now, and then hopefully you have a strong woman who helps you become a better man. And that's definitely not the one who he has. Right. And with all due respect, I don't know her, don't care to know her.
Right.
But I'd work for her. I'm just kidding. And you're paid. But no,
I think you make a very valid point.
But you're right too, Louis, because I knew Donda. She's a good friend of mine, and she's been over my house several times. And I totally agree with you about when he lost his mother and how devastating it was, because that was the most endearing, most close person to him, who he would listen to, who she had some kind of realm over his behavior that would guide him and help him along. He really did go over, and he's kind of like lost out in the ionosphere behind that now. And he cover coats it and hides it, and he's so defensive now behind that. And he still really needs
Well, no, whatever he's doing right now, he's tripping.
Yeah, he is tripping.
A man needs to stay. That's why he's got to make sure he's got bodyguards.
Because of the loss of his mom.
Because a man needs to, every time a man needs to step to you and say,
and I'm always curious, do you think he feels responsible for that?
No, he does not.
No.
As far as his mother?
Yes.
Well, I think there's an unknown that still bothers him. There's an unknown because he didn't fully investigate the doctor.
No, but the doctor, but I know the doctor, Jan. Dr. Jan was
He worked
name.
With Dr. Murray, I heard, for a while.
No, but when she had her surgery, it was with Dr. Jan. No, but
if
no.
he wasn't as successful as he was, would she have been able to get the plastic surgery in the first place?
No.
But let me tell you why she did it. Because she
probably financed it.
No, but she wanted to do it because actually she was dating my brother Spalding. He's like my play brother Spalding at that particular time. And he brought her over to my house several times. We played cards. We talked. I talked to her and we engaged in a lot of conversation and different things. And she did it because she had found love again. Mm-hmm. She was very inspired to have somebody. She was, you know, a little overweight. As we do as young ladies, we want to, you know, make sure we look good for our man or people that we're going to be with, and she was feeling this and wanting to enhance her beauty, and it's done here in Hollywood, Beverly Hills, and all that.
Yeah,
however,
that
the thing that happened was that she had too many things done at one time, and she really was not overseen. She should have stayed there. The doctor did offer for her to stay there in the hospital, that you know, in that facility, and not go home. And she wanted to go home. You know, it was just. Nobody's fault, really.
Unfortunately.
And she had the right thought and idea. What she did, she probably wouldn't regret having done. But at the time, she had it done all together. For her, she was having her breast done and her liposuction, a bunch of things.
What happened to Usher's wife, too? Remember, Tamika, you know, she almost died, too. And Usher had to fly out to wherever she went, Brazil or wherever it was.
That's right.
I mean, people have to be careful with those plastic surgeries.
No, you just
got to
be careful when you hang out with Usher.
Yeah.
Swimming pool, you out of luck when you was a little kid. You don't watch nobody.
Well, we got to begin to wrap the show. This is our last show of 2013.
Bye-bye, 2013.
We'll be back in 2014. I want to let everybody know that on January 7th, we are launching a crowdfunding campaign through Indiegogo, which will fund to build a studio for Reach Around Radio, Radio Freaks, and hopefully the Kathleen Bradley Show.
You know that's right, baby.
And so we'll be giving you more information on that. January 7th, we are launching our Indiegogo campaign. So please support so we can have a permanent home for Reach Around Radio.
Now what do they get?
Right, though, you know what? You have to incorporate some Skype. Skype so people can be on the radio show as well. And that's what I think a lot of people... Since, you know, I'm from back east and Midwest and all that, and they don't have the capability to be on the magnitude and level that your show is having and giving, and they want to know that their friends know that they're on Skype, just like, you know, TMZ and everything. So you should offer something of that
magnitude. We're gonna do it a lot different than we did at the other spot.
So what are we
giving
away?
Also, when you donate, there'll be some really cool perks. So they'll know when we launch.
Gotcha.
Can they come and hang out with me for a week?
Also, somebody can win a chance to kick it with Louis Dix for a week. Also, please.
Kick Louis Dix.
It does come with a gun and a rope in case you want to kill yourself. It does
before,
come with
before the week is out.
Also, please download our Reach Around Radio app. It is available on Android and iTunes. What? Come in here always. I don't know what the hell you're saying.
Uh-oh. Get her a blunt stat.
Mixes on the app also, remember?
Yeah, there you go.
Oh, yeah, you'll be able to go to the website and check out DJ Always'
DJ
mixes
Always.
Whenever we get one on SoundCloud. And
I hear they're really good, though. He's giving sign language just like the dude that was right at the funeral for Mandela.
Right. So please download our mobile app. Also, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. That's
please.
Reach Around Radio Show. And then follow me, OG Poetess, on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook, and Fuck Speedy. Next. Happy New Year, everybody. Thank you so much for supporting the show. We love you guys. Team RAR, have the best holiday, and we'll see you on the page.
It's your boy, Speed Doggy Dog. Check me out on Instagram.
For what?
It's Speedy is funny. That's Speedy IZ funny.
Impossible.
My son is doing very well in soccer. He's the only black kid on the team, and he scores all the goals. You Mexicans better get it together. The little black brother's taking over everything. And my other son, his little Latino team, they won the whole park division. They were champs. Anyway.
Are you going to go through them all? This is going to take a while.
No. And my other...
Are you going to go through all?
I ain't seen the family.
Get in there, Louis.
Ten up.
Hey, it's Louis Dix. Thank you, guys. It's always fun reading those insulting remarks you put on after I come on.
I'm
really
sorry.
Appreciate that. I went 11-0 on my flag football team, 7th grade. Willows, we won. We're champs. We are perfect. Shout out to my son going abroad for 3 weeks. Studying, so we're excited. Baby girl's due back in 2 days, and I miss her like crazy. And
wow.
And yeah, all
that's
good.
It. Next class.
Jordan Carmichael Pilot.
Get out of there.
Check me out on Instagram and at Claudia Jordan. Lots
what?
Of pictures there. Lots of stuff from New York and my trip to Africa and
the baby picture?
Dominican Republic.
Sonogram.
hilarious. I'm not gonna be pregnant anytime soon.
Yeah,
maybe.
You're
no, pregnant. Next year I will be pregnant.
You're pregnant.
I'll have a baby next year.
Right.
Seriously.
Oh wow, that's deep.
I get that billionaire in Africa, honey. I don't care how ugly.
She's gonna be down.
What about the thousandaire in Valley Village? What about that? What about that?
My show got greenlit on Centric. It's myself and Finesse Mitchell. It's called According to Him and Her.
Nice.
It's a relationship show. Thank you. And we just got greenlit for 12 episodes starting in January. So we start production. So very happy.
Baby.
And a new film called Secret Effect, where I play a really shady, manipulative record exec. Yes. Yes.
Congratulations.
Good. Thank you very much. Things are going
nice,
well.
Claudia.
Teeter.
Shout out to Elliot, Deshaun Thomas, Donald Holliday, Ronald Harvey, Christine Taylor, Andre Jones, Otis Goodwill, and Keena Jasper. And poetess Jean-Claude Big Pun Walker said, what's up?
What up?
TDP, Mr. 123 Knox, baby, that's Facebook and Twitter. Happy New Year's to each and every one of you. And please make sure you download and tell your friends to download our app. That is on iTunes. Make sure you support Reach Around Radio and everything that goes with it.
I want to take this moment before you step in there, baby, and say that I want to wish you a happy, happy birthday. Get some headphones, please. Tita, thank you.
We're going to give her some alcohol.
Fuck up.
I will not.
Once again, I want to just say to you, baby girl,
use your finger,
that you have a happy, happy birthday. Won't your pussy get fixed?
Stupid.
I want you to get everything that's coming to you, baby. So until your pussy gets fixed.
Oh, wow. Slow down.
Big Daddy be waiting on you, baby.
Little Daddy.
Why are you speaking on me?
I don't feel nothing.
Happy birthday, fam.
Thank you.
Happy birthday, fam. She said that was pretty.
It was pretty.
You sound like a girl.
Sexy. Let's see. On Twitter and Instagram, you can hit me at Nikki Pam with 2 K's.
And you can look me up at RT Steckle and RT Steckle Comedy. Thank you very much, guys. And please stay tuned for 2014. We're going to do some big things. Appreciate y'all.
Right. And thank you all so very much for having the courage to invite me back.
That's all right.
And make sure you get your stuffing stuffer. Okay, KathleenBradley.tv. My book.
What's the name of it?
At the Price is Right, Memoirs of a Barker Beauty.
Yes, get
and
that.
It's a really good read. It's fun. It's good. It's enlightening and what have you. So, you know what? God is good. Glad to be here. We've lost so many people in this last year, but you know what? We're celebrating life right now and moving on to 2014. And be healthy, be wealthy, be well. God bless you.
So we got to make sure we get everybody in here.
Yep.
Go ahead, bro. Say something, man.
Shout out to Wayne Wizzle Johnson as well.
Bitter Man. Come on. Hurry up, because it's the last show. Go ahead.
I wanted to give a shout out to my camp, Her Nation. Go ahead and check out our latest mixtape. It's called Dreamland LA. You can catch it on hotnewhiphop.com. Go on hotnewhiphop.com under the mixtapes tab. Search Dreamland LA, and you'll find all the stuff from Cradle La Biz, new project, and everything is mixed, mastered, and recorded by myself.
All right, too.
Yeah.
All right, DJ Always.
All right, all right. Happy New Year.
Get in there.
Your man voice.
Just want to say I love y'all. I love everybody.
Aww.
That was gay.
He ain't gay. He only sucked my dick one time.
Johnny Gill said you can't kiss.
Big things coming up in 2014.
What's his name?
I thought I was supposed to be spending the Christmas party, but Speedy.
I'm going
to
hook it up. I got you.
Hilarious.
All right, cool. Come on, bicycler.
Come on, Sonny.
Biker.
All right, what mic? Oh.
Any mic.
Damn, you was loud as well.
No, I just want to say Happy New Year, Merry Christmas, and everything else to everybody, and enjoy, and hope everybody has a peaceful love-filled time.
All right.
A love-filled time.
Wow. That was super bad.
How creamy was that?
Did you take a gay pill?
Yeah. Yeah, gay candy.
We love you, Team RAR, and we'll see you in 2014. Thank you.
Shout out to the studio for letting us do our thing, too.
Yes. Yeah.